रिकॉर्डिंग चालू आहे ना? ओके नाही नाही आता चालू करतो. ओके गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. आय वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द टुडेज प्रॅक्टिकल सेशन ऑफ दिस मेटलर्जी सब्जेक्ट. नाउ टुडे इज आवर सेकंड प्रॅक्टिकल. प्लीज लेट मी नो दॅट आय एम क्लिअरली विजिबल ऑन युअर स्क्रीन. दिस ग्राइंडिंग मशीन इज ऑल्सो विजिबल ऑन युअर स्क्रीन अँड माय व्हॉइस इज क्लिअरली ऑडिबल. ओके नाव वी विल स्टार्ट दिस सेशन. नाव इन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट दी स्पार्क टेस्ट. ओके दिस इज आवर सेकंड प्रॅक्टिकल. दिस इज दी स्पार्क टेस्ट प्रॅक्टिकल. नाव initially we will discuss the aim of this practical, why we are performing this practical, and the next step we will discuss the theory related to this and procedure to conduct the practical, then how we are going to take the conclusions from after performing the practical, and what are the precautions that you have to follow while performing this practical. Okay, now this is the spark test. And this spark test generally we are using for doing the sorting or classification of ferrous and non-ferrous alloy. And after identifying whether it is a ferrous or non-ferrous, we can do further classification in the ferrous materials and their alloys. Like suppose whether it is a steel or whether it is a cast iron. And if suppose it is a steel, then which kind of steel it is? Whether it is a plain carbon steel, or you can say that low carbon steel or high carbon steel, or whether it is a alloy steel, that we can highlight or that we can conclude after completing this spark test. Okay, but there is one drawback, or you can say the limitations of this test. We will not able to identify the correct composition. Whichever material is provided to you, we will be not able to identify or detect its correct composition, means exactly how much carbon percentage is there, or how much iron is there, or suppose it is a non-ferrous alloy, then which alloy it is, you cannot say that. Okay, now for conducting this spark test, okay, our ultimate aim is to do the classification or to sort whether it is a ferrous alloy or whether it is a non-ferrous alloy by observing the spark pattern. Okay, this will be our aim. Now theory, first I will tell you the procedure, and after that I will tell you the theory related to it, and then we will perform actual operation with the help of Jadhav sir. Okay, and now for conducting this spark test we require some sample specimens. Okay, different sample specimen I have collected, non-ferrous alloys, then tool steel is there, then mild steel, it will come under the category of plain carbon steel, then I think we are also having, okay, we are having different samples, tool steel sample, then mild steel, this is plain carbon steel sample, mild steel or low carbon steel you can say that. Then we are having tool steel also. Okay, then from this is the cast iron also we are having with us, cast iron, and from non ferrous I have taken the aluminium. Okay, aluminium alloy, different sample I have collected, or in this experiment they will provide you different samples. And what will be the question here? They are not going to ask you the exact composition. Just they will ask you, just do the classification or sort it out. Depending means whether it is a ferrous alloy or whether it is a non-ferrous alloy. And if it is a ferrous alloy, you have to identify whether it is a steel or a cast iron. Like this, only this much you can do with this help of this spark test. Okay. The further briefing related to its composition, you cannot do with the help of this spark test. That is the limitation of this process. Now, for conducting this spark test, we have taken the samples. Okay, these are the sample materials, and this is the grinding machine. Okay, this grinding machine is only these two are our requirements: grinding machine and test specimen. Now, what we are going to do? Just we are going to take these materials, whichever sample material is given to you, and we are going to on this grinding machine, and just simply you have to perform a grinding operation. Simply, we are going to perform a grinding operation, and after performing the grinding operation, whichever spark is generated or spark is created, that pattern you have to observe. Okay. Now, while observing its pattern, how it is created or why it is created? These type of questions may be asked in your oral examination. Okay, oral exam or sometimes in your competitive examination in MCQs, they can ask this question: why spark is created? Suppose in ferrous materials, generally a spark is created, and in non-ferrous materials, no spark will be there. Then why it is? This question may be there. Then I will explain it. Now, when you start the grinding operation, what will happen? This abrasive wheel is rotating with high speed. Generally, its RPM is in the range of 3,500 to 5,000 RPM. Okay, revolutions per minute. Speed will be within this range only, up to 5,000 RPM. Then, when you start the grinding operation, what will happen? There will be a friction between the rotating abrasive wheel and your test specimen. Due to the continuous friction, what will happen? Heat will be generated. Heat will be generated, and due to continuous heating or while performing that grinding operation, due to the continuous heating, what will happen? Whichever particles are there in your test specimen, okay, it will get heated. And they will reach to a stage, it is known as the incandescent stage. Incandescent is nothing but a stage where it becomes a red hot in color due to the continuous heating, red hot in color, and it will get detached or it will get loose from that material and it will get thrown out. Okay, when it will happen? When that particular particle will reach to a stage termed as incandescent stage. Okay, at that time, incandescent is nothing but it will become red hot in color. Whenever we are doing continuous heating, it will, that material will become red hot, and due to the continuous friction, that particle will get thrown off. Okay, and it will be having some color. Okay, due to the continuous heating, it will be having some color. That's why it will get thrown off and it forms certain lines in the air. That lines created are termed as carrier lines. Okay, these are the carrier lines. What is the reason behind generation of these carrier lines? Continuous friction between abrasive wheel and your test specimen. Continuous heating, it will create the that particle will reach to incandescent state and it will get thrown off from your grinding machine or from that particle material, and it will get thrown off in the air and it will form some lines, and that lines will be termed as carrier lines. Okay, now this is related to the carrier lines. Then if suppose whichever test specimen you are using, it contains carbon, if some amount of carbon is there, then what will happen? When that particle is thrown off in the air, when it is thrown off in the air, it comes in contact with the oxygen present in the air. Okay, then what will happen? Oxidation will take place and it will form the carbon dioxide. Okay, in the same way, if it is a ferrous alloy, it contains iron, then iron will come in contact with the air, which is air, or you can say that oxygen. It will react with the oxygen which is present in the air and it will form iron oxide. Now, during the oxidation process, what will happen? Generally, whenever oxidation process takes place, heat will be released. Now, this particle is thrown off, and in that thrown off particle, oxidation is occurring, and due to that oxidation, heat is released. And due to that heat, that particle will explode. Small particle is there, it will get exploded, or some explosion will occur, and that explosion is nothing but, or you can observe that explosion in the form of burst or spurt. आपण मराठीमध्ये त्याला थिंगी म्हणतो, थिंगी दिसते बघा असं आगीची. तर ती कशामुळे तयार होते थिंगी? इट इज ड्यू टू दी ऑक्सिडेशन. ऑक्सिडेशन आल्यामुळे काय होतं, हीट रिलीज होते, हीट जनरेट होते आणि ते पार्टिकल एक्सप्लोड होतात. त्याच्यामुळे काय होते, आपल्याला ती थिंगी दिसते. अँड इट इज टर्म्ड ऍज बर्स्ट ऑर स्पर्ट. ओके, इन युअर मेटलर्जिकल लँग्वेज बर्स्ट ऑर स्पर्ट. ओके, नाव in this grinding process, first I have explained you the carrier lines. Carrier lines are formed, then burst or spurts are formed, and in non ferrous alloys no spark will be there. Spark is not generated. Okay, directly material removal will occur, directly particle will get removed. Okay, means they are not containing the iron or carbon. Due to that, oxidation will not occur there. That's why they are not creating any kind of spark. Okay, so this is the theory. Now we will ask sir to perform on grinding operation on all particles. Now while making the observations, you have to follow some precautions or precautionary rules or safety rules are there. Okay, while performing this operation, you have to follow certain safety rules. Please wear the safety goggles. If possible, gloves are there, you can wear that also. And then wear proper shoes. All these whichever safety rules are there while entering in the workshop, you have to follow that. And now the other rules or precautions which you have to take while observing or conducting this practical is that whenever you are performing the grinding operation, proper pressure should be applied. Okay, pressure should not be too less. If too less pressure is there, no spark will be generated, then all materials are non ferrous for you. Okay, if no spark is there, you will say that this is non ferrous alloy, this is non ferrous alloy, all are non ferrous alloy. This case will happen. And if you are applying excess pressure, what will happen? Due to more pressure, darker spots or more bursts will get generated. Okay, so proper pressure should be applied. Then whichever sparks are created, while observing that spark, your line of vision should be at 90 degrees. Okay, it should be at 90 degrees. And whenever you are performing this operation, you should take care that minimum 25 centimeter spark should get generated whenever it is a plain carbon steel. Suppose you should do the this grinding operation in that way. And while observing, the standard conditions are you should observe this in a little dark environment, okay, or you can say that controlled light environment. Then and then only proper pattern will be visible. Here I think in this environment we are having too much light is there, that's why clear visibility will not be there sometimes. Okay, then another thing, whichever spark is creating here, you have to protect it from the air contact. Means suppose air contact manje hava jast nasli pahije tithe. Okay, due to the air it will get drifted. Whichever pattern is producing, it may get some drift due to the air speed. Okay, these precautions you have to take. Means related to the pressure, then the angle of your vision or line of vision, then light conditions. Okay, light conditions, and it should be protected from air so that whichever spark is created or pattern is created, it will not get disturbed. Okay, now we are going to conduct this practical. Now you will say that how we are going to determine whether it is a plain carbon steel or whether it is a cast iron. Okay, whichever pattern will get created, that we are going to compare with already available charge. Already what we have done, with the known samples, we are knowing this is a plain carbon steel or it is a mild steel with this much carbon percentage. Okay, means with the known composition specimens, we have already performed this, and whichever spark is created, from that we have prepared one standard chart. Okay, standard spark test chart is there. From the known composition samples, we have prepared that, and whichever spark will get created here, we are going to compare this spark test or whichever spark pattern is there to the that standard specimen chart, and we are going to identify whether it is a non-ferrous alloy or whether it is a ferrous alloy, and if it is a ferrous alloy, in between that, whether it is a steel or cast iron, and if it is a steel, whether it is a plain carbon steel, in that it may be low, medium, or high carbon steel, or it may be a alloy steel. Okay. If any doubt is there, you can ask me. Now I will ask Jadhav sir to perform this grinding operation. Please, while when sir is performing this operation, please observe the pattern. Sir. Now, please while you can perform it. हाँ तुम्हें सांगा कि नाव सांगा जोरत दिस इज माइल्ड स्टील ओके हियर यू कैन वॉच द पैटर्न क्रिएटेड दिस लॉन्ग लाइन्स आर कैरियर लाइन्स एंड दिस स्मॉल स्पार्क दिस आर बर्स और पर्स एंड एज इट इज ए प्लेन कार्बन स्टील माइल्ड स्टील इज योर लो कार्बन स्टील You can see that whichever carrier lines are produced here, these are having longer length. Okay, longer length sparks are created, and they are luminous, or brightness is more. Wait. Please observe the length of the spark created, and then observe its color, and how much amount of bursts or spurts are there. You have to observe that. Okay, observe its length, then its color also. Whenever it is having lower carbon percentage, it will produce more length. Okay, low carbon steel gives you more length of that. Whichever spark pattern is there, more length will be there, and it will be more brighter or more luminous in color. As carbon percentage increases, it will become darker or reddish in color, and as carbon percentage will increase, more amount of burst or spurts will be there. Okay, now again sir will do the operation on mild steel. It is a low carbon steel. Please observe the length, okay, and the quantity of the burst or spurt. Okay, please keep this in your mind and compare it with the cast iron, where carbon percentage is more. Color will get changed, length of the spark will get changed, and amount of that burst will be also different. Okay, this is the low carbon steel cast iron, right? Na ha kaise alag alag cast iron rakho. Okay, ha, now this is the cast iron sample. Okay, now you can observe that the color is darker, reddish, and carrier lines are less, and amount of burst is more. Okay, here you can observe more bursts are created here. Okay, more bursts or spurts are creating. Carrier line length is very short, up to this much, and color is reddish in color. Why it is happening? Because this is cast iron and it contains more carbon. And due to that more carbon, oxidation is more. That's why bursts are more. Shinge just this side aplyala carrier lines kami ahet ani hacha color pan kasa ahe reddish color ahe. In plain carbon steel color is brighter. Okay, anki konta ahe tool steel asel ha kutla ahe Okay, this is the alloy steel. Okay, as compared to plain carbon steel, length of carrier line is little small. But if you compare it with cast iron, length is longer. Okay, and it is more luminous, brighter. That is alloy steel. Tool steel will come under the category of alloy steel. HSS. This is again HSS. High speed steel. Okay, here we are having little bit more carbon percentage, or here some alloying elements are more. Okay, alloying element they may accelerate the process of oxidation in some cases, or they may slower it also. Okay, now हे कुठलं कुठलं हे म्हणलं ते टूल स्टील आहे ना हा ज्ञानखेक दाखवते आपण त्याचं कम्पॅरिझन करतो ओके दिस इज प्लीज ऑब्झर्व इट अगेन दिस इज टूल स्टील प्लीज ऑब्झर्व द लेंथ ऑफ कॅरियर लाईन देन अमाऊंट ऑफ द बस क्रिएटेड Here, carbon percentage is little less as compared to HSS. Okay. Now we will see the HSS. Now in this is HSS high speed steel. Here, due to the change in the some carbon percentage and some alloying elements are there. Okay. Due to some alloying element, its color is different, little bit reddish color, and then length of the carrier line is also very small. Okay, now this is non-ferrous alloy, aluminium alloy. Okay, if you observe carefully, no spark is created here. This is non-ferrous alloy. Okay, from that non-ferrous alloy, it is aluminium alloy. Aluminium will be parent metal, and other alloying elements may be there. This is brass. Brass is the copper alloy. Okay, copper will be parent metal, and zinc will be there. Copper and zinc alloy. No spark will be created. Okay. As carbon and iron is completely absent in non-ferrous alloys, they are not means no particles will get oxidated, or oxidation process does not occur here. That's why that burst or sparks are not created. Okay, directly material removal will occur in case of non-ferrous alloys. Okay. Thank you. बंद करो दे दे बंद केलं बंद केलं ओके नाव इन दिस वे वी हॅव परफॉर्म द ग्राइंडिंग ऑपरेशन ऑन प्लेन कार्बन स्टील ओके डिफरंट सॅम्पल्स वी हॅव कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम प्लेन कार्बन स्टील वी हॅव चूजन माइल्ड कार्बन स्टील ओके इट इज अ माइल्ड कार्बन स्टील इज नथिंग बट लो कार्बन स्टील वेअर वी हॅव ऑब्झर्व दॅट length of carrier line is longer or more length is there its color is luminous or brighter color will be there and very small amount of burst are created then we have taken another sample of cast iron okay cast iron is also ferrous alloy but what we have observed whichever carrier lines are created carrier lines are having shorter length and its color is little bit reddish and amount of burst is more as more carbon is there more oxidation is occurring okay more oxidation is occurring hence more bursts or spurts are created then we have observed the high speed steel from alloy steel category high speed steel and tool steel okay In that we have observed that whichever tool steel is there. It is producing carrier lines with more length and luminous color. And in high speed steel, carrier line length is very short and its color is little reddish. Why it is so? Due to some alloying elements. There are certain alloying elements. It may be tungsten, chromium, like that. Number of alloying elements are there, molybdenum. Depending on that alloying element, oxidation may get accelerated in some cases. In case of high speed steel, we observe that alloying element accelerates the oxidation. Due to that, whichever carrier lines are there, they are reddish in color and some amount of burst is also there. And in case of tool steel, we have observed that oxidation is retarded. Okay, due to that, burst is a little less and carrier lines are brighter in color. And in case of non-ferrous alloys, we have performed grinding operation on this brass and aluminium alloy. Brass is the alloy of copper and zinc. Okay, brass is alloy of copper and zinc. And then the next sample we have taken is aluminium alloy. Okay, and we have performed the grinding operation and no spark is generated in case of non-ferrous alloy. In this way, with the help of this grinding machine and by performing the some small grinding operation and observing the spark pattern created related in that spark pattern, you have to observe the carrier lines. Okay, carrier lines and burst. While observing the carrier line, what we you have to observe length of carrier line, then number of carrier lines. Okay, means we are not expecting exact count, then just the amount, whether it is in lesser amount or more quantity. Just we are expecting the quantity. Sorry. While observing the carrier lines, you have to observe its length, then its quantity, color. And then you have to observe the burst. In the burst, you have to observe its size, shape, its color, and its intensity. In how much quantity it is generated. Okay. This is the spark test. And this spark test will be very helpful for us to do the sorting of the materials. Okay. In that, we can sort it as a ferrous alloy and non-ferrous alloy. And within ferrous alloy, we can do the classification whether it is steel or it is a cast iron. And in steel, we can do further classification whether it is a plain carbon steel or whether it is a alloy steel. Okay. Can you tell me? Okay. Now, if you are having any query or any doubts or questions, you can ask me. I will wait for a few minutes here. Please enter that in the chat box if any query is there. And if no doubt is there, you can mention that also in the chat box that no doubt is there or no query is there. I will wait for a few minutes. Okay, please let me know any doubt is there. If no doubts are there, you can enter your roll numbers in the chat box for the attendance purpose. And one announcement or is there related to that voter ID registration. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, one announcement is there for that or notice for you related to that voter ID registration. I have sent one link or one Google form. If you are already a registered voter, then please may fill all details in that Google form and write your voter ID number and attach one photo of your voter ID. Okay. And if you are not registered or if you are not having voter ID with you, please, I have mentioned, okay, I have sent the link. One YouTube link is there. Watch that YouTube link. Then which documents are required, I have also sent that details to you already. Please refer that. Please watch that YouTube video. And please do the registration. And after doing the registration and uploading all documents, you will receive an acknowledgement or a reference ID number, and you have to fill that Google form with the help of that reference ID number. Okay, those who are not having voter ID with you, please complete this activity within next 1 hour. This data I have to send to the university. Okay, please complete it on emergency basis. Already in the morning, I have given you a special 30 minutes for that activity only. Only 30 to 35 students have sent me detail. Okay, I will repeat it again. Those having voter ID, already having voter ID with you, just open that Google form, fill your details. Okay, whichever details are mentioned there in the Google form, and mention your voter ID number and attach one photo of your voter ID. And those who are not having voter ID with you, please watch the YouTube link which I have shared on the our group. Watch that YouTube video. Then with the help of the link provided in the group itself, please do the registration. And after registration, upload your document. And after uploading your document, submit that form. And you will get a reference ID number or acknowledgement number. And with the help of that acknowledgement number, fill the Google form, which I have shared. Same Google form you have to fill. Just you have to mention the reference number. And after following all these steps, suppose some students are telling you that they have registered already or applied for voter ID with the help of some agent or some other person, please take. If they have registered on your behalf, then take the reference ID or acknowledgement number from them. And fill that Google form with the help of that reference ID number or acknowledgement number. Or whichever receipt they have received on your behalf, please upload that receipt. Okay. Okay, please complete this activity. And if you are having any doubt related to today's practical session, means today we have conducted this Spark Tech. This is the practical number 2 from our syllabus. If you are having any query related to this, you can ask questions. If you are not having any questions, please put your roll number in the chat box for attendance purpose. Whether I am audible or not. Why these are not visible here? Please put your roll number. Okay, if no doubts are there, all points are clear from this practical. Today we have conducted this Spark test for doing the sorting or classification of the materials as ferrous, non-ferrous, and within the ferrous, whether it is a plain carbon steel or alloy steel. If any doubt is there, you can ask me. Now I will stop this session. Please put your roll number in the chat box. please put your roll numbers in the chat box. Oh, if no doubt is there, as we have completed this practical session, park test session, practical session, you can leave the meeting by entering your roll number in the chat box. Thank you for attending this session. You can continue to your remaining session. Thank you.